Honorable President of India, respected President of Bharat Scouts and Guides, Dr. Anil Kumar Jain, dignitaries attending this function, adult leader, awardees, special invitees, representatives of print and electronic media, scouts, guides, rowers, rangers, brothers and sisters. It gives me an immense pleasure to extend a warm welcome to Honorable Rashtrapati Ji and to all of you present in this august ceremony. I feel greatly indebted to Honorable Rashtrapati Ji
for his kind consent to grace this award ceremony. I am extremely happy to welcome Dr. Anil Kumar Jain, our newly elected young and energetic President of Bharat Scouts and Guides. I congratulate all the esteemed awardees and the scouts and guides, rowers and rangers for being felicitated today for their devotion and dedication for the Scout Guide movement. The Rashtrapati Award was instituted and sanctioned by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the first President of India in the year 1961. This ceremony is continuing since then. In today's ceremony, 195 scouts, guides, rowers and rangers are present on representative basis. Though the award has been earned by 7,559 scouts, guides, rowers and rangers. They have earned this award based on the principles of scouting, such as world brotherhood, service to others, patriotism, character building, self-reliance, duty to God, and duty to country. I also say and submit that Bharat Scouts and Guides is the largest non-political youth organization in the country with 57 lakh scouts and guides as members. It's also a gender-balanced organization, as we amended the rules providing for 50% reservation for women from guide wing on all the elected positions. The scouts, guides, rowers, rangers have worked hard and become eligible to earn this prestigious highest national award by acquiring skills, useful skills and human values, thereby enriching their personality. 43 adult awardees are also being honored for their unparalleled efforts and giving their best for taking this movement forward both qualitatively and quantitatively. Our members actively responded to the appeal by Honorable Prime Minister of India, and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is being implemented all over the country in the movement enthusiastically. Our scouts and guides and adult leaders participated in various international events, both sponsored and self-financed, and brought name and fame to the organization. The national headquarters was vigilant to ensure that more number of young people participate in international events organized by OZUM and WAGS, which are the world bodies. The Bharat Scouts and Guides has been recognized as the messenger of peace, as hero of messenger of peace by OZUM for the community service and the development activities done by our scouts and guides. We have already started the project Stop the Violence for our guides under the sponsorship of WAGS. We have been conducting training camps on Stop the Violence in almost all the state associations of the country. The other two projects for girls are Free Being Me and Surf Smart. These two projects are also sponsored by WAGS, which help the girls to improve their body confidence, self-esteem, and also protect and make them more careful in surfing. I'm also happy to say that Bharat Scouts and Guides will host the WAGS World Conference from 18th to 22nd of September 2017 at New Delhi. About 700 lady participants will come and represent 146 member countries. I'm confident that the Young and Adult awardees will continue to remain associated with the movement in some capacity or the other. They will also always remain prepared to help the society, especially during natural calamities, and also that they will demonstrate the Scout Guide values in their dealings with other fellow countrymen. Similarly, our adult leaders will also try their level best to enhance the quality of the movement and will take this movement still forward. Jai Hind. I now request respected Sri Anil Kumar Jain, President Bharat Scouts and Guides, to kindly come up and present a scarf to Honorable President of India.
Thank you, sir. And now we come to the presentation of awards to adult leaders for their meritorious contribution in the field of scouting and guiding. We request our Honorable President to give away the awards to adult leaders. Now first come the awards, the highest award in the country, Silver Elephant. Sri Kedarnath Kashyap, Honorable Minister from Chhattisgarh. Sri Santosh Kumar Mal, KVS, that is Kendri Vidyalaya Sangathan. Sri Ashutosh Arvind Kumakoni, Maharashtra. Professor Dr. Daljit Kaur, Uttarakhand. Srimati Saroja V. Naidu, Karnataka. Sri Dinkar Buratoki, Himachal Pradesh. Sri N.K. Ambikesh, Northeastern Railway. Sri Chandrasingh Gwal, Uttarakhand. Sri Goru Channabasappa from Karnataka. Sri Balachandran Parachotil of Kerala. Ms. Lal Rosangi, Mizoram. Srimati Shobana Suresh Jadhav, Maharashtra. Sri Diego R. Fernandez, Goa. Sri Shamal Kumar Karak, Eastern Railway. Sri Appasaheb Baburao Shinde, Maharashtra. Srimati Kanta Khoeli from Delhi. Mohammad Bashir Shawal from J&K. Srimati Kusum Harishchandra Londe, Maharashtra. Next award is Bart Silver Star, Sri Lakshmikant Shukla of Uttar Pradesh. Srimati S.K. Prabha, Karnataka. Srimati Hema Vijay Kumar, Karnataka. Sri M.K. Khan, Karnataka. Now the award is for Silver Star, Sri Ashutosh Garg from Railway Scout Guide Board. Srimati Rithelma Pasa from Meghalaya. Sri N. Srinivasan of Karnataka. Dr. Padam Chand Jain of Rajasthan. Sri K. Lalrit Nulangwa of Mizoram. Srimati Danorkar Rajani Nana Saheb from Maharashtra. Sri Tulsi Prasad Dungel of Sikkim. Sri Manoj R. Nayar of Central Railway. Sri Aloysius Raj Alexander of South Central Railway. Srimati Kempi Pakam of Arunachal Pradesh. Dr. Trej Pratap Singh of Uttar Pradesh. Dr. K.B. Gurumurthy of Karnataka. Sri Abdul Jamil, Karnataka. Srimati Prabha Londe of Karnataka. Srimati Sarala Ashok Bosale of Maharashtra. Sri Achal Chandra Pradhan of Orissa. Sri Jaspal Singh of Punjab. Sri M. Revana Siddappa, Karnataka. Sri Gajanan B. Mannikeri of Karnataka. Now the Rashtrapati Award for Scouts and Guides, Andhra Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh. Assam. Bihar. Central Railway. Chhattisgarh. Delhi. East Coast Railway. Eastern Railway. Gujarat. Haryana. Himachal Pradesh. Jammu and Kashmir. Jharkhand. Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. Karnataka. Kerala. Madhya Pradesh. Maharashtra. Manipur. Meghalaya. Northeastern Railway. Northeast Frontier Railway. Navodaya Vidyalaya. Northern Railway. Orissa. Puducherry. Punjab. Rajasthan. South Eastern Railway. Sikkim. Southern Railway. Tamil Nadu. Telangana. Tripura. Uttar Pradesh. West Bengal. And Western Railway. Now the awards to rovers and rangers, Assam. Central Railway. Chhattisgarh. Eastern Railway. Haryana. Karnataka. Kerala. Madhya Pradesh. Northeastern Railway. Northeast Frontier Railway. Northern Railway. Orissa. Punjab. Rajasthan. Southeastern Railway. Southern Railway. Uttar Pradesh. West Bengal. And Western Railway.
C.K. J. George, Minister, Karnataka. Sri Kedarnath Kashyap, Minister, Chhattisgarh, Dr. Anil Kumar Jain, President Designate for Scouts and Guides, Sri V.L. Nagrali, Chief National Commissioner, Dr. Mrs. V. Vijayalakshmi, National Commissioner, Guides, dear awardees, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. At the very outset, I would like to welcome you to this historic hall, which is popularly known as Darbar Hall. This Darbar Hall is the mute witness of so many contemporary events which have profoundly influenced the lives of not only people of Indian subcontinent, but a large number of persons outside that region. I'm glad to have this opportunity to spend this afternoon with you. The Scout and Guide's fundamental principle of doing one's duty to God and country and service to fellow being has also been the fundamental ethos that drove the act and duties of so many historical figures who took the oath of doing so in this historic building. The first President of the Republic, when we declared ourselves as the Republic and made the very basic act for ourselves, by ourselves, after 190 years of British rule, and the man who presided over that assembly, known as the Constituent Assembly, was shown in this very hall as the first President of the Republic on 26th January 1950. At the stroke of midnight of 14th, 15th August 1947, when the colonial rules of 190 years came to an end, that epoch-changing event took place in this hall when power was transferred by Lord Mountbatten, the last representative of the Crown in this country, to the Indian hands, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, as the first Prime Minister of India. Therefore, I am glad to have this opportunity of receiving you here. I am informed that the tradition of Rashtrapati's award certification has continued since 1961, when the first President of the Republic, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, associated himself with the Bharat Scouts and Guides Association. I was here just a couple of days back to pay tribute, along with others, to this great soul of India, at the portrait of his. Over the years, this award has inspired many scouts and guides to work towards nation building, and it is indeed heartening that starting at a tender age, they grow to become individuals working for national integration as well as international harmony. The movement of scouts and guides is a unique platform available for the youth to learn through experience the values of friendship, hard work, harmony and humanity. The founder of this movement, Lord Baden-Powell, started the movement in our country in 1909. I'm glad to know that Bharat Scouts and Guides, with a membership of about 5.7 million, is one of the largest non-governmental, non-political, voluntary and educational youth organizations in our land. This is a mammoth resource that can be undertaken to massive transformation if it so desires. I'm told that the members of the Bharat Scouts and Guides have actively responded to the appeal of the Prime Minister for actively participating in the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, that your volunteers are enthusiastically implementing it throughout the country. I congratulate them. Dear friends, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan also celebrates dignity of labor, a value that was so dear to our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Young friends, I exhort to you to become messengers of values that seek to create a just and compassionate social order. Each one of us must be mindful of the sensitivities of those around us and the effect of our work and actions on them. We must collectively preserve the core values of pluralism, compassionate coexistence, and secularism that have served over the millennia to safeguard the fabric of our society. The Bharat Scouts and Guides must infuse a greater sense of tolerance in young minds whilst allowing them to summarily reject any divisive agenda. I am also happy to note that Bharat Scouts and Guides is continuing to enjoy a prominent place in international scouting and guiding. Scouts and guides and adult leaders are participating in various international events and have brought name and fame to the organizations and the country as a whole. Distinguished participants, it is with a sense of great satisfaction that I note the wide spectrum of activities that the Bharat Scouts and Guides have been engaged in over the years. The efforts and the events have encompassed humanitarian aid during the natural calamities, social campaigns to combat disease and debilitative habits, community workshops for skill development, joint activities related to Millennium Development Goals, and participations in international meets. I congratulate each and every member of the organization for the selfless services rendered not only to bring succor to the deprived and the needy, but also enhance the reputation of our country in the eyes of the international community. I am informed that the initiatives of World Association of Girl Guides and Girl Scouts, such as Free Being Me, Stop the Violence, Surf Smart, and initiatives of World Organization of the Scout Movement, such as Messenger of Peace, are being implemented very effectively. A meritorious contribution to the Messenger of Peace initiatives by the Scouts and Girls, which is matter of great pride for us and Bharat Scouts and Guides, is one of the first three in all national scout organizations in the world level. It's a matter of great satisfaction. Dear young friends, in the end, I would like to take the opportunity to underquote the words of the vision statement of Bharat Scouts and Guides, and I quote, "By 2024, the Bharat Scouts and Guides will be a globally visible, constantly going and self-reliant premium youth movement that is gender-balanced, vibrant, and responsive to trends." With these words, I once again congratulate the award winners, young scouts and guides, rovers and rangers, including the adult leaders of the movement. May your meritorious service be the lodestar for others to follow suit in the coming years. I hope that the young awardees will continue to remain and associate themselves with the movement in some capacity or the other. They will also always be prepared to help the society, especially during national calamities, and also that they will demonstrate the scout and guide's values in their dealings with other fellow citizens. I wish you, awardees, a very bright future. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, respected President of Bharat Scouts and Guides, Dr. Anil Kumar Jain, respected Chief National Commissioner, Shri Nagrale Ji, respected awardees from Scouts, Guides, Rovers and Rangers sections, all other dignitaries and special invitees, all unit leaders and escort teachers who have assembled here. On behalf of 57 lakh members of Bharat Scouts and Guides, I express my heartiest gratitude to Honorable President, who has graciously presented the awards to adult leaders, Scouts, Guides, Rovers and Rangers who have assembled from different parts of the country. Sir, we are always thankful to you for the love and affection you always bestow on the members of this organization who are rendering noble service to the society. Let me take this opportunity to also thank Sri Rajneesh, IAS, Private Secretary to President of India and his team, and also Group Captain Sri Sanjeev Sethi, Deputy Military Secretary to the President of India and his team, for extending their support to us in making this award ceremony a successful and memorable one. Our sincere thanks to the awardees, special invitees, and all other guests who have graced this occasion. Last but not the least, our thanks to all the staff of Rashtrapati Bhavan who have always been supportive to Bharat Scouts and Guides. Once again, I thank you all. Jai Hind.